Hi guys, welcome back to another edition of Math in a Hoodie. I'm so excited you're here today. I've put on my favorite hoodie and we are going to talk about telling time. And this is part two of telling time, okay? So hopefully you watched part one where we learned how to tell time with a digital clock. Do you remember? With a digital clock, it just tells us the time. We don't have to guess. And it's divided by the colon in the middle, right? And it tells us 3:52. The first number is the hours, and then the number on the other side of the colon is the 52, okay? And that tells us the minutes. Do you remember from the part one? So the digital clock just tells us the time it is. It's super easy. We just look at it and we see the numbers and we know. Well, this time we're going to talk about the round clock, which is probably what you see in your classroom, huh? Yeah, this is called, I like to call it the round clock. It's also called an analog clock, and that's kind of a fancy word. So I'm just going to stick with the round clock for today, okay? All right, so the round clock also tells us what time it is, but it's not as simple as a digital clock, is it? It doesn't just tell us right away what the time it is. We have to be able to tell by looking at the face or the front of the clock. We have to know what these numbers mean, and we have to be able to figure out what time it is by using these long, long things. Do you know what these are called? Do you know what they're called on a clock? They look like arrows, don't they? We have a small one, and then we have a long one. See how they're two different shapes? One is small, and one is long. Do you know what they're called? They're not called arrows. They're called hands. Isn't that funny? We call this the face of the clock, like your face. And we call these the hands. They're not like our hands, are they? These are the hands of the clock. And what the hands tell us is what hour and minutes it are. So the analog clock or the round clock breaks the time into hours and minutes, just like the digital clock. Okay, we just have to know how to figure it out, okay? So there's two different hands, right? Which one do you think tells us the hour, and which one do you think tells us the minutes? Do you know? Take a guess. What do you think? Well, for the hours, it's the small hand or the small arrow, okay? The small hand is for the hours. And the long hand tells us the minutes, okay? So whenever you look at a clock, you'll know that the small hand is telling you the hour, okay? And did you ever notice when you look at a clock that they both turn in the same direction? They both go around the clock in the same direction. And we call this clockwise. Now they don't turn together, because one's going to tell us the hour and one's going to tell us the minutes. So they don't turn together. They turn at different speeds, don't they? But they both turn in the same direction. Okay, another thing to notice about this round or analog clock is how many numbers are on it. Does it go up to 50 or 100? What does it go up to, guys? Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, there's 8, it was hiding, 9, 10, 11, 12. It only goes up to 12, doesn't it? So if our small hour hand goes around, how many hours could we ever have? Could we have 50 hours on a clock? No, we couldn't have, because it only goes to 12. So we can only have up to 12 hours. Now, we have more than 12 hours in a day, don't we? Do any of you guys know how many hours are in a day? It's 24. We have 24 hours in each day, and this only goes to 12. So what happens when we get to 12 and it's already gone to all of the hours and it's back to 12? It doesn't mean it's a whole day, right? We have to do it again. And 12 plus 12 equals 24. So once the hour hand's gone all the way around the clock two times, then that means it's a day, because there's 24 hours in a day, but there's only 12 hours on the clock, okay? The first 12 hours are AM, and there's a video you can watch about what AM means, but AM is before noon. So the first 12 hours of the clock are the morning hours, or AM, and then when it starts over, the last 12 hours of the clock are the PM, or the afternoon and the nighttime, okay? So AM and PM is a different video, but that's how we divide the clock up. We do one time around is AM, and then we start again, and the second time around is the PM, and that equals the whole day. That's 24 hours. Okay, guys, so for the last part of this video, we're going to focus on the shorthand. And do you remember what the shorthand shows us? Because it shows the hours or the minutes. Do you remember? It shows us the hours, huh? The shorthand or the short stick or arrow, whatever you, whatever it looks like to you. They call it a hand, but whatever it looks like, the short one is the hours. So I went ahead and wrote 5 different hours on digital clocks on the board. Now notice, none of them have minutes, do they? They just have the hour. And that's because we're just gonna focus on the hour for a minute. So, what we're gonna do is look and see what hour is in each of these clocks, and we're gonna turn our small hand to that hour. So we're not gonna move the minute hand right now, okay? We're just gonna practice with the hour hand. All right, let's look at the first one. What time is it? What hour is it, guys? It's 1, huh? So we're gonna take our small hand and put it to 1. That would show us it's 1. Just like this clock says. And then whatever the minutes would be, that's what we would put the large hand, huh? Okay, let's look at the next one over. Actually, let's go to this one. This says 7. Okay, guys, so where are we gonna move it? Are we gonna put it on the 4? No, we're gonna put it on the 7. That shows us that it's 7 o'clock and something hours, but we don't know yet, huh? Okay, let's try this one. This says 11. It's 11 o'clock, guys. So should I put it on the 5? No, I should put it on the 11. See how I did that? This tells us what hour it is. It's 11 o'clock. Okay, now let's do this one, okay? That one says 2, huh? Let's go ahead and move our hour to 2. It's 2 o'clock. Okay, see how we can tell what hour it is? And then we match up the small hand to coordinate with that. They're the same thing. This is just telling us what the number is. And this one, we have to find it. But we're smart, we can figure it out. So this one says 9. Let's move the small hand, not the big one. Let's move the small hand to 9. There we go. 9 o'clock. Now I have a trick. I have a tricky question, I guess. What if you saw the small hand between 2 numbers? What if it wasn't directly right on a number? What if it was between 2 numbers? This time I moved it between 6 and 7. So guys, is it 6 o'clock or is it 7 o'clock? What does that mean? We know it's gonna hit the 7 next, isn't it? Because it goes this way. So if it's in between 2 numbers, the hour that it is the one that it just passed, right? It's not yet to 7, is it? It started at 6 and it's slowly moving to 7, but it's not there yet. So it's not 7 o'clock, okay? It's still 6 o'clock, but it's getting close to 7, isn't it? Let's try one more. What if I put it between 10 and 11? Can you answer? Would it be 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock? Can you remember from what we just said? So it hasn't got to 11 yet, has it? It's going to move to the right and it's going to get to 11, but it's not there yet. So that means that it's still 10 o'clock and it's almost 11, huh? It's slowly moving to 11. See how the numbers get bigger? So whatever the larger number is, you know that that's the hour that's coming up, right? So if it's between the 7 and 8, it's still 7. It's not 8 yet, but it will get there really soon, okay? All right, so in the next video, we're gonna talk about the minutes, the long hand. But I hope this video has helped you learn how to know what the small hand means. It's the hour, right? And how to know which way a clock goes and how to tell the hour on our round or our analog clock. Okay? So thanks for stopping by, guys. You did so awesome. And I'll see you next time on Math in a Hoodie.